Hi, I'm Aki Vehtori. This is a video clip for Bayesian data analysis course. Topic is now introduction to the course contents. And you can find all the material available at the website shown in this slide. So in this course, you will learn to do different types of typical data analysis used in science and in industry and so on. For example, treatment control. So for example, we have a randomized patients to treatment and control groups. And then we want to know whether the treatment is effective. Instead of patients, this is close to also A-B testing. Also, if you would do websites and different type of website, and you would like to test which one users prefer, and so on. Also, we can go then to continuous value treatment. So what is, we randomize patients with different dosages. We can also do design of experiment to choose these dosages, which dosage is sufficient without too many side effects. Or what if we also know more about these patients? Is the treatment effect different for males and females, child or adults, light, heavy? And possibly we know more about them, about the genes and so on. And so many different types of these analyze types, and then the kind of the basic analysis types we go through are then easily extensible to more complex cases after the course. The benefits of Bayesian approach in these different kind of data analysis cases is that we integrate over different uncertainties to that we are able to focus to interesting parts. We can use relevant prior information, but we can also use quite weakly informative priors. We can use hierarchical models to combine information from similar groups, but which don't need to be exactly the same. And it's the Bayesian approach also offers kind of principled, natural way of doing model checking and evaluation. In the course, we go through also necessary about things about the computation. So in the Bayesian approach, we need to be able to compute expectations with respect to posterior distribution. And so we have these integrals where we have the posterior distribution P theta given Y. And then there can be some function which, like g theta. And then we can integrate over this posterior distribution to get the expectation of this g theta. And so it is easy to write this math, but then the actual computations are not easy. In simple cases, it is possible to have analytic solutions, but this works only for very simple models. And then most of the course discusses about the Monte Carlo and Markov chain Monte Carlo methods, which are very generic and also basis for the probabilistic programming, which makes it also easy for the generic use. There's a little bit in the end of the course also about distributional approximations, like the Laplace approximation, a few mentions about the variational and expectation propagation. In this course, we use the probabilistic programming framework STAN. The probabilistic programming makes it easy to focus on the modeling part, describing the model. There's a the programming language to describe the models, but then we have the automated inference. So when you change the model, modify the model, it's quick to also remake the inference, and we go through these Markov chain Monte Carlo methods so that you also understand what's going behind. But when you go to more complex models, it is enough that you understand what's going on, but you don't need to develop or write your own inference methods for each new model you are using. And then these probabilistic programming frameworks also provide diagnostics, because the automated inference is not foolproof, so it can fail sometimes. And also there's diagnostics, whether the model is sensible compared to data, and so on. We use Stan. I'm one of the Stan core developers, and Stan is one of the most used frameworks. Especially when used with R or Python, there are additional packages making its use very easy. Here's an example, just the simplest type of model we go also through in the course. We have two groups of patients, treatment and control group. There's a binary outcome, for example, whether the patient died or not. And then we ask, is the treatment useful? And this is just to give you a quick idea that how it looks like when we then use this probabilistic programming language Dan to write this, that we describe data, what kind of data goes in, what are our parameters, what is our model, what other things we can compute, and we go later in more detail at different parts. There are also some interfaces. For certain class of models, we can write also the models in more shorter format. Like here, this is the same model, but we can write it in this easy, the shorter format. But then the full standard language then gives us more flexibility. So we start with the course with basic models and distributions, which can be used as a building blocks for then the more complex models. Basic computation, which is then builds the basis to going to this elaborate MCMC algorithm in Stan. We have typical simple scientific data analysis cases, and then we also spend some time how to present the results. I mentioned also in the beginning of the clip, there's the website. It's a Git repository where we have all the material. So you can find slides, additional chapter notes. So there's additional information about the chapters we go through. Reading notes help you to focus on most important parts, exercises, including peer grade rubrics, a lot of demos in R and Python, extra reading material, useful links to extra material, and so on. See you next time.